Hi, this is Lehman Baird.
Hi, this is Mance Harmon, CEO and founder of Hedera Hashgraph.
I have a question to ask you.
Have you heard the gossip on Hashgraph? Let's get started.
What is he talking about?
And who am I? That's a secret you obviously know. You know you like me. Hashgraph.
Hello, everyone. It's the Gossip Guy here. And before we get started, let me just say thank you for an incredible year from the world powered by Hashgraph. From the announcement of the Hedera Hashgraph public network to the launch of the Mainnet, projects beginning to develop on top of the platform, and the inaugural Hedera 18 developer conference, it's great to see that Hashgraph is really beginning to take shape in advance of the open access of the network set to take place in 2019. So, given all these developments, I couldn't resist the opportunity to make a video to look back at all these developments over the past year, while also calling out some of my own personal highlights. Now, before we start, and unlike some other Rewind videos out there on YouTube, if you enjoy this video or just a fan of Hashgraph, be sure to leave a like, as this video wouldn't have been made possible without you. Thank you. Okay, so the year kicked off with January, where there was already some buzz and hype surrounding Hashgraph, especially following Mike Maloney's Hidden Secret of Money YouTube series, which had featured the technology, and was also the time that many folks in the community were first introduced to the Hashgraph consensus algorithm. January was also the time that I launched my first video. And as a refresher from that first video and for Hashgraph overall, it is a consensus-based algorithm that was invented by Dr. Lehman Baird back in 2012 via the company Swirls. It offers the same benefits of other consensus mechanisms that power other distributed public ledgers. However, it leverages gossip about gossip protocol combined with a virtual voting algorithm that achieves fast, fair, and secure properties. It's fast, as Hashgraph incorporates a signature, a timestamp, and two cryptographic hashes into every transaction using only a small amount of data. Those two hashes note the last message that had been made and the last message that had been received, i.e. gossip about gossip. Now, unlike blocks of transactions in a blockchain, through Hashgraph, we can easily construct every transaction throughout history using a graph to simply link those hashes together. Those hashes enable the graph of transactions to be stored into memory with less data, allowing for greater throughput of transaction volume. It's fair, as transactions order is sorted in order of events, not by blocks, and are determined by the consensus timestamp, or the medium of the received time the active nodes in the network had received the transactions. The fair ordering enables virtual voting. And of course, it's secure, as Hashgraph uses a directed acyclic graph data structure, which, when you factor in those benefits that I explained before, the Hashgraph consensus algorithm ultimately achieves asynchronous Byzantine fault tolerance, which is the highest degree of security for a distributed computing system. So with the quick explanation of Hashgraph out of the way, the name the Gossip Guy comes from the gossip about gossip protocol that powers Hashgraph, along with a sarcastic twist at the popular TV show Gossip Girl, which was based in New York City, where I also call home. Okay, on to February, when I started my weekly Gossip and Hashgraph series, which focuses on summarizing the news and developments from the Hashgraph ecosystem. Back then, we covered the launch of the Hashgraph Developer Advocacy Program and developer Discord communities, early partnerships, media coverage in Bloomberg, and of course, community developments. However, March was when things really took shape and when we learned about the Hedera Hashgraph public network during the launch event in New York City. It was during this event that we were first introduced to Hedera by CEO and co-founder Mance Harmon. As we learned, Hedera is the public distributed ledger network that leverages the Hashgraph consensus algorithm. Its key attributes are its performance, security, stability, and governance, which address some of the key requirements for market adoption for distributed ledger technologies. On the performance front, Hedera allegedly processes over hundreds of thousands of transactions within only a few seconds of latency. For security, the Hashgraph algorithm is ABFT, and when combined with a proof-of-stake model on the network, Hashgraph is resilient to several security threats, including distributed denial of service attacks. Hedera achieves stability with a combination of technical and legal controls. As many are aware, the Hashgraph consensus algorithm is patented, which has caused some controversy within the crypto sphere. However, as we understand, the patent is only in place in order to prevent the network from forking, and the code base will be subjected to open review. Lastly, there is governance, which is very unique to Hedera. Open consensus with permission governance is what they call it. Hedera is governed by a council of 39 world-class organizations across industry sectors and geographies. Each member has an equal share in governance with no single entity controlling the network, including Swirlds, the creator of Hashgraph, which is on par with the other members. As we understand, the governance approach for Hedera is modeled after that of Visa, which was developed by DeHawk back in the 1960s. Topping all this off is the product features of Hedera, which includes the cryptocurrency for micropayments, file storage, and a virtual machine that enables Solidity smart contracts that will ultimately power decentralized applications. This was obviously a lot of exciting news and jump-started the series of events that would take place in the months ahead. We also took time to learn more about the Hedera Hashgraph Council in an interview I had with Tom Trowbridge, president of Hedera Hashgraph. Now, I know that there has been some very opposing viewpoints on Hedera's approach for governance centered around the 39 council members, which even till this date still haven't been announced. However, I think the approach that Hedera took is pretty reasonable and is similar to that of a board of directors that you see on public companies. And ultimately, the council is in place to ensure the continuity of the network and to prevent against any single party taking control of the network and ultimately impacting consensus. Some may not like this approach to governance and some may call it centralized. However, I think we can't pass any judgment until we see the network running and also the council in action. Wrapping up this busy month of March, we also learned of some of the first projects announcing the plans to build on top of the network. This included Intiva Health, a medical credentialing record repository, and ArtBit, an artist recognition platform. April, May, and June were best associated with travel. The Hedera Hashgraph team went on their global tour, making stops in Asia, Middle East, Europe, and wrapping things up at the Crypto Vests conference in Los Angeles, California in May. Special call out to the Hashgraph ambassadors that helped make the global tour possible. In case you're not familiar, the Hashgraph ambassadors are a group of community members around the world that host educational events and also meetups in their local communities. While the Hedera Hashgraph team was on the road, I personally took some opportunity to do travel myself, making stops in Dublin, Ireland for the Dublin Tech Summit, where I connected with the Hedera team and also Mingo, a messenger app being built on top of the platform. Then on to Salt Lake City to attend the first meetup there, which happened to be hosted at the Overstock.com campus. After that, went on to Stockholm, Sweden, where I got to connect with my good friends at Block Wars, a team of developers looking to build games on top of distributed ledger technologies, including Hedera. By the way, this was one of the most fun interviews that I did all year, so thank you to the Block Wars team. And wrapping things up, we went on to Tallinn, Estonia to host a meetup event there. At the time, Estonia ranked number one on Google Trends for the highest amount of search volume for the keyword Hashgraph. Thus, this was pretty cool to connect with all the various communities around the world. July, we saw more projects join the ecosystem and coverage for Hedera, including a mention in acclaimed author and technology advocate George Gilder's latest book, Life After Google, The Fall of Big Data and the Rise of the Blockchain Economy. July was also the time that I hosted my first live stream, all made possible by active community member and trusted co-host, SupremeX67. But things picked up in August when Hedera announced their accredited investor crowd sale and wrapped up their total fundraising of $124 million. As we understood, 6% of the total $50 billion in token supply had been allocated to these investors and would be released upon day one of the open access of the network, and approximately 10% of the total supply would be made available by the end of 2019. During August, I also had the opportunity to sit down with Tom Trowbridge on two separate occasions in order to learn more about the token's role in providing security to the platform, token supply, and also how distribution would take place, including the Hedera Hashgraph Council's role over this. Be sure to check out these videos when you get the chance. There was also my interview with the Sagewise team, who are developing a dispute resolution framework for smart contracts, and also a project that I'm closely watching. What I like about Sagewise is they're developing products and solutions that stretch across multiple distributed ledger technologies in addition to Hedera. But the biggest highlight of this month had to be the launch of the Hedera Hashgraph Mainnet on August 24th, 2018. This was when Mance Harmon and Lehman Baird went back to the original Starbucks in Cedar Park, Texas to press the button and stand up the mainnet. All things considered, this had to be one of the biggest milestones of Hedera to this point, and would also set the course for the developments in the months ahead. Concluding August and into September, more projects join the ecosystem, including a personal favorite of mine, Hero.fm. Starting off the month of October was the announcement of the Helix Accelerator program, which is the first ever Hedera Hashgraph Accelerator that was launched by the Hong Kong-based venture capital firm Mindfund. Starting in February 2019, aspiring projects looking to develop on top of Hedera Hashgraph and from all over the world will participate in Helix's first class. Following this announcement, we headed into the cornerstone event in October, Hedera 18. This was the inaugural developer conference in Dallas, Texas, and also served as an opportunity for the community to get together and learn more about Hedera Hashgraph, especially following the release of the public APIs. To kick off Hedera 18 was the Global Distributed Hackathon, which took place across Singapore, Bangalore, Moscow, Tel Aviv, Paris, London, San Francisco, and of course Dallas. Teams from all over the world participated and served as an opportunity for developers to get their hands on the Hedera SDK for the first time and build DApps on top of it. The overall theme of the hackathon were micropayments, which still stands as one of the leading use cases for Hedera overall. However, the winner of the global hackathon was Paper, who developed a gateway for web-based payments that can be used to access online content or API calls. It was demonstrated using HTTP, and also a special call out to Paper team member and good friend Alex Malz on his accomplishment. We really hope that you continue to pursue Paper. Following the hackathon was a day-long series of presentations from Hedera-based developers and keynotes from the Hedera team. During the event, it was also announced that the Hashgraph consensus algorithm was formally validated as asynchronous Byzantine fault tolerant by a COQ proof, which is a formal proof verification system. This ultimately helped validate the previous claims by Hedera on the security of the algorithm overall. Also, in case you missed any of Hedera 18, be sure to check out the playback that the Hedera team has included on their YouTube channel. Throughout Hedera 18, I was also in attendance in Dallas and had the opportunity to meet many of you in the community and also landed several interviews with the Hedera Hashgraph team. However, for me, the most interesting part of Hedera 18 was the crypto economics presentation made by Dr. Lehman Baird, where we got further insights into transaction fees, proxy staking, and also were introduced to the Mirrornet. The Mirrornet is a pretty interesting development as it is essentially a copy of the Mainnet. However, it gets pushed transactions throughout history. I can see there being some very interesting business use cases coming out of this, especially as the Mirrornet could serve as a cheaper alternative to storing transaction history. However, don't take my word for it. During my interview with Lehman, the Mirrornet was a topic that he got most excited for, so definitely keep an eye out on further developments surrounding this. Following October and Hedera 18, further versions of the Hedera SDK were made available in other programming languages. Developers also began getting access to the testnets in order to jumpstart the development of their applications. Additionally, the Hedera portal became open to the community in order to set up their accounts. And we conclude the year with some of the most exciting news for the community, the announcement of the Hedera Wallet and the community testing program. For the wallet, users have the ability to download the Hedera Wallet app and also link their Hedera portal accounts to it. The best part is that the wallet provides access to the mainnet. Now, there's several variables to consider in setting up this, and also there's some very helpful resources to guide you through the process. However, the creation of users' wallets is a notable milestone in the development for Hedera overall. And building onto this, Hedera recently announced the community testing program. Through this, developers and users have the ability to test the mainnet and testnets and earn 1,000 HBARs in doing so. The testing will focus around the Hedera Wallet app and some sample applications, including the daily timestamp, a content site geared to demonstrating micropayments. So these were pretty cool new developments as we round out the year.
So that's it. That wraps up our look back at the world powered by Hashgraph in 2018. It's pretty cool to think that at the start of the year, we only had a white paper, but then quickly learned about the Hedera Hashgraph platform, and we wrap up the year with a mainnet up and running and soon to gain access to it. I'm sure in the years ahead, we will look back at 2018 and realize how much of an important year it was into the development of the platform. We're still in the very early stages of development, and I'm most excited for what's to come next, especially the projects and applications that are gonna be built on top of the Hedera Hashgraph platform that we might have not considered before on other distributed ledger technologies. Above all else, I'm grateful to be a part of this community and also experience it alongside you. Thank you to all those that have viewed my videos and the subscribers that continue to support this channel. I'm really looking forward to 2019, especially as we lead up to open access. Also, I want to give a shout out to SupremeMax67, who's been helping me out along the way. I greatly appreciate it and look forward to working together in 2019. With that said, this is the Gossip Guy signing out. Happy New Year, see you in 2019, and hello future. And lastly, if you like this video and want to see more, like and subscribe to my channel, The Gossip Guy, as we gossip about a world powered by Hashgraph. Thanks for watching.